Welcome back to Shadow the Hedgehog Reads, Chapter 14 of The Walking Dead, Hope. I'm Shadow the Hedgehog. Now let's continue where we left off. The sun was beginning to set to the left, casting long shadows of the trees on the road ahead. Louis sat on the right side, staring absently at the staggering walkers on the side of the road. 20 minutes into the trip, he'd already counted at least 30 of them. That's almost double the amount they were this morning, he thought. Dismissing the thought, he looked over at AJ on his left. The boy was fidgeting with his hands, looking down at the floor. 5 years after they met, AJ was already gaining height of Louis. By now, his adopted son nearly reached his chin. Already as tall as Clem, Louis stroked his afro, smiling at the boy when he turned. He'd promised to take care of him for the last time he'd seen Clem, and he intended to keep that promise. About an hour of silence later, both cars pulled on the side of dirt road. They parked them facing the road in case they needed to make a quick getaway. The group helped in hiding their cars as best as they could. They were already shrouded in the darkness of night. By the time they finished brandishing their respective weapons, they all ventured into the woods. "Keep your eyes peeled," Johnny called from in front of the group as he smashed a walker's head with his bat. "He's pretty good with that thing," someone commented to Loomis under his breath. "Yeah, and that's Javier Garcia," he replied with a smug grin. "Garcia?" repeated Asim, scrunching up his face. Why does that name sound familiar? "He played for the Clementine Indians before all this happened," Louis exclaimed, almost loud enough for the object of their conversation to hear them. "That's right," Asim said, snapping his fingers. "Isn't he also the guy who got kicked out of the major leagues for betting against his own team and playing badly on purpose?" "Technicalities," said Louis with a shrug. The whole chat was cut short when Javier shushed them a few paces ahead of them. They all halted their walk and kneeled, forming a small semicircle around Javi. When Louis questioned why they stopped, Javi just pointed. They followed their finger and gasped when they saw what was ahead of them. Hundreds of walkers groaned and moaned their way through the forest, barely 50 feet from them. They seemed to be walking their way toward northwest, only a few stragglers breaking their ranks. Over the undead's heads, they could see the top of the compound's walls, a faint glow emanating from beyond. Louis stood up with a huff and kicked the ground. "Darn it, darn it, darn it," he cursed, closing his eyes and balling his hands into a fist. "Will you keep it down?" Gabe called under his breath. "You'll bring all the muertos to us." "We might as well do that," Louis snapped, throwing his arms in the air. "How are we supposed to get past the smelly patrol and get to my wife without getting chomped?" Gabe stared at him, seemingly out of ideas. The rest looked at Louis with frowns on their faces. Pity, he knew. He hated when people gave him that look. There was enough spare in the world for people to add onto it with their pitiful lies. "Don't look at me, I don't know," he snapped, kicking a small tree log that lay by the large oak tree. "You know, I think I may have an idea," Johnny said, scratching his beard. He inspected the herd with sparring eyes. When he approached one of the walkers that had wandered close enough to them, he looked back at the others. They all gave him a confused look with varying degrees of curiosity. Louis was the one who spoke up. "What do you have in mind?" Javi grinned at the freckled man, eyeing his immaculate clothes and shaking his head. "You're not gonna like it." And that was Chapter 14 of The Walking Dead, Hope, the Walking Dead fan fiction written by Goofy Gomez. What do I think of it? I actually find this to be really interesting. Both paragraph and sentence structurings were really good. I like the fact that Louis actually got a surprise when he got back to his room. AJ, Violet, and Asim actually came back and decided to give him a Javi the backup, or an army in this case, to get Clementine back. And for Javi's idea on how to get inside the right arm space, well, I just hope that plan really works, because I'm almost sitting at the edge of my seat while I was reading this. All I can say that so far, the story is really good, and overall, this chapter is really amazing. Now, what do you all think of this chapter? Did you all like it or did you not? Feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. And are you enjoying this story so far, or are you not enjoying it so far? Don't forget to let me know in the comment section down below. Well, I better get some rest. I'm about to call it a night because I have an early morning mission at GUN. Tomorrow morning, anyway. But thank you all very, very much for watching. This is Shadow the Hedgehog, signing off. So long.